After the meeting with BIDCO, affected farmers and residents, it was resolved that some palm trees are cut down so that people of Bungo can get access to power. The government will not pay for any tree being cut down, as the company wanted in the first place. They have so far cut one tree as a sign of acceptance, and all those which will be removed have been marked. We are just waiting for a letter from Oil Palm Uganda Limited effecting this order. I want to thank residents for being kind and calm, and also journalists for your publicity. Abe Mukalu, the Oil Palm Uganda Limited spokesperson, applauded residents for always following law and order, and he added that the residents did not destroy a single tree during their strike. I thank you for liaising with local leadership, but whenever there are misunderstandings, reach to us, because the project is here for you and you are here also for the project. We need cooperation in all aspects. Leaders led by Rajab Semakula and Paul Lwasa have appealed to the company to always respect road reserves where such developments should be set up. Today we are here after the consensus between Oil Palm Uganda Limited and district leadership that let them accept the loss and avail people with this development. Bambala Zabwe Semakula, one of the residents in the nearby village of Bungo, says that though the company boosted islanders' development, they should not destroy people's properties such as playgrounds, among others. Though such projects bring development, they should observe reservations for other developments. They removed people's playground and never stopped on that, but also denied people the power to decide on other necessities such as power. Residents have expressed their happiness after achieving this milestone and applauded government for a quick intervention. Earlier this week, locals blocked Kalangala's main road over denial of leeway for power line, where Oil Palm Uganda Limited was asking the government to pay 500,000 shillings for each palm tree to be cut down. Report compiled by Samuel Nkuba for the news.